there's no arrangement for rendition of fugitives from Hong Kong back to China. So I think they are taking the law in their own hand. And that's why, you know, the many people become immediately very, very alerted, you know, to the situation that the mainland authority is now, you know, taking the law in their own hand and acting in such a overt manner with total disregard to the one country, two system. I think this incident has really posed another very serious and adverse impact on the rule of law and the constitutional order of Hong Kong. This incident, you know, particularly after, you know, the booksellers case, would cause further alarm to both the political and the financial community in Hong Kong. People who have some background connection, or people who have migrated to Hong Kong from the mainland, will become very concerned and become even very fearful about this case, which may pose to them as another precedent in the legal history of Hong Kong or in the political history of Hong Kong. The message is that he is warning the authority in the mainland not to do anything that may harm the reputation of the country and also cause threat to the one country, to the confidence of the people on one country, two system. And then the last message in the announcement is that he is reminding the Canadian government that he is a Canadian citizen, and the Hong Kong government that he is a resident in Hong Kong. So, you know, in a subtle way, he is calling for help.